over here at Arnie's gym with Macaulay Mcgowan. How's it going, Macaulay? Good that training session there for you again?
Yeah, it's good, yeah. Just ticking over now, two weeks ago. So just back in gym learning, staying fit.
You're 4-0 now, busy 2014 for your made your pro debut in Liverpool, didn't you? And has it gone according to plan and how you thought pro career would go in the first year?
Yeah, it's gone better. I've been on massive bills as well. Last bill was massive, I've been on BoxNation. Been on top card, so I've been really fortunate in that respect. But it's been a hectic year, a lot of learning, it's been non-stop, but I've enjoyed it.
And as an amateur, you was a really good amateur. I saw a couple of your fights. So anyone not seeing you going into the pros, maybe they might have been a bit surprised at how well you've took to it, really.
Yeah, as an amateur, I did have a very amateur style. I could box, fence off, and, proper being amateur. But in the gym, I always knew I could adapt. So when I did go pro, I still had a very amateur style, but I knew I would adapt. Stand me in good stead training for a good 5 months before I actually made my debut in the pro gym and pro environment. But it did stand me in very good stead.
So you've always been around the pros, haven't you, now for especially this last year and that Arnie's gym, you've been going over to Macklin's in Marbella, so good sparring, good surroundings and people
tough.
Around.
It's been very tough, but you don't realise how good boxing is, but at the same time you don't realise how hard it is.
Would you have thought your style would have, because you was a really good amateur, great boxer, going into the pros, did you have any reservations of how your style might go over, or was you confident?
I was confident I could adapt to anything. I knew I could adapt. I knew it weren't there, but I knew I could adapt to the pros. And I've always been aggressive. And in the gym, as an amateur, we would have tear ups and we would sit down on our shots and have a good fight in sparring. But when it comes to fights, it's a bit tippy top and stuff. So I knew it was there. It was just then taking that into the fights. And I think first two, I was still a bit amateurish, but the last two fights, I think I've really talked to
them. What were the main differences for you?
I don't know. It's how switched on you got to be, I would say. You wear small gloves on and stuff. You can't be taking dash shots. You've got to be switched on. You know what I mean? Every shot's got to be banged on. Otherwise, you're going to get caught. You're going to get hurt. Especially against older, tougher men.
You find the tougher, even like the every level.
Hit him some people on the head, it's like, wow.
How'd you talk that? And you've got nothing lined up, have you, now? You've hopefully early in the new year you're going to have something.
Well, I'm looking to get out as much as possible, but staying in the gym, I love coming to the gym. Like, it's quite relaxing now knowing that I've got nothing in the pipeline, but I can just settle down and proper learn and keep improving.
You with Arnie. Arnie, learning plenty, great sparring, haven't you? So you're good.
Well, we've got Paul Butler in the gym, we've got other lads in the gym that we can all look up to. And even lads that you consider on the same level as you. You see them sparring or do some on the pads, and you think, wow, I can take from that. It's not just Paul, it's other lads as well.
Yeah. And you had your fights on BoxNation as well, and great reviews off the people who know what they're talking about, so.
Yeah, first time I watched it on YouTube, and I was put it up dead and loud to hear what they're saying and that, and I was scared they were going to say something bad, but luckily, didn't say anything bad really, so it was nice.
Nice one, mate. It's been great to see you. Let's hope 2015 is as successful as the first year of your career. Yeah, definitely. All the best, Macaulay.
Thanks.